Ah, yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Well, hi everyone. My name is CC Washington. Well, I'm important, aka CC Washington. And today I am giving you a history lesson on Chuck E. Cheese 2.0. Not the company itself, but the dance floor itself. But if you don't know, 2.0 dance floor really is terrible. So I'm gonna explain you why the dance floor is really bad. Larry, roll tape. Okay, Corbin, we're rolling. Okay. Let's see. Wait, why isn't the intro rolling? Sorry, Corbin, I forgot to press play on the video. Larry, please do so now. Oh, I'm so fire you. Sorry, Corbin. All right, Larry, roll tape. All right, Corbin, we're rolling. Anyway, the history of 2.0 starts in 2013, but apparently the CEO of Chuck E. Cheese is replacing all locations that currently have the animatronics with not a dance floor, not a light show, but a TV. That's right, a TV. That's how 2.0 literally is right now. Anyway, phase one is starting.
Hey guys, I've now switched to my text-to-speech voice, because my voice is tired. Anyways, from a news report I read from CBR, the story quotes, "The kids' restaurant arcade Chuck E. Cheese's is getting another major brand overhaul, and it's losing the thing it's most famous for." According to Today, the chain will do away with the infamous Munch's make-believe band, offering a far less unsettling place to eat your pizza and entertain your children. Along with this huge shift, the company is also doing a major overhaul to its look, pay format and safety formats. Next time you visit your local store, you simply choose the time you want to play, starting at just $9 for 30 minutes of play, a representative for Chuck E. Cheese's said, adding that this new system will help parents keep track of how much they are spending and the location of their children. Although the restaurant was first known for the live entertainment of the animatronic band, as technology and audience tastes started to advance, the singing, dancing, free robots became a little less popular, and a lot more antiquated. They became a bit of a running joke for the brand, and this could be why the company decided to abandon the format altogether. The company first announced it was making changes in 2017, but this latest round of press reveals some major shifts in the business model and general format of the restaurant. Chuck E. Cheese's is going to look very different from what most people remember from their childhood, and the modern updates will embrace technology. The restaurant's general aesthetic will get an update, as well, offering a sleeker look, better lighting, and contemporary signage with a new font. The new play design will also include an interactive dance floor, with a life-size Chuck E. Cheese wandering around. All of a sudden, people like Matt the Franchise, CEC show stars, and me were reacting to the dance floor removal. The fact that CEC is removing animatronics is not cool, and a bad decision to do so. Also, take a look at this video from CEC show stars.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! Give it up for your favorite mouse, Chuck E. Cheese!
Alright guys, are you ready? Here we go. 2.0 dance floor, more like redesign. This thing sucks. It has a dance floor, a TV, and no animatronics. End of rant.
I remember the sickness was forever. I remember snuff videos. Cold September's the distances we covered. The fist fights on the beach. The busies wound us up. Do it all again next week. An embryonic love. First time that it's scarred. Embarrass yourself for someone. Crying like a child. And the boy you kicked Tom's head in still bugs me now. That's the thing, it lingers and claws you when you die.
Teens in rage, spiraling in silence. And I arm myself with a grin, cause I was always the joker, buried in the humor amongst the wine.